Guys, welcome to my channel. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share. When you look at the interface, this is what you're going to get the moment you open the Photoshop CC6. This is the interface. Let's do some little settings before you can continue. Have you seen at the top here, we have the menu bar. We have the file, the edit, the image, the layer, the type, the setting, the filter, the 3D, the view, windows, and help. Under it, there's a standard toolbar. They've written that place as auto search. Please check the auto search. Click on it. There's a box there that can allow you to check. Then you go to show transformation. Then you click, you also check that one too. So this is the major thing, the minor thing we have to do before we can start it. To have any design, you need a background, you know. When you are going to paste either that particular poster on a car, the cover of your laptop, invitation card for wedding, that of the funeral and other stuff, you need a background. And where can you find this background? Don't forget that always backgrounds are always based on our dimensions. So this is where you go. You go to file. Have you seen where file is? Then you click on file. When you click on file, this menu will appear. Then you click on new. We have new, we have open, we have browse in bridges. You click on new. When you click on new, a pop-up menu will appear. Over here, you go to presets, then you select international paper. When you select international paper, it will give you A4 with the A4 dimensions. Then you click on OK. So when you click on OK, it will come like this. Maybe you don't want this one too, but you want a different one. You also go to the same plane, that is file. You click on file. A pop-up menu will appear. You click on new. When you go to new, it will come. When it comes like this, you know where they have written the size, the A4 sheet. You can convert from the A4 sheet to a different sheet. We have A6 and A5 and A3, B5 and C. We have all these ones there. When you click on A3, you know A3 is equivalent to 2 times of that of the A4. So you can also convert from the A4 to A3. Then you click on it. Dimension in Photoshop is very important. Sometimes you might take your own dimensions. Maybe the dimension of your phone, you want to paste a poster at the back of your phone, or you want to paste a poster at the back of your fridge or that of your laptop. You want a new design of something, or you want to place that particular design on a wall, but your dimension wasn't fine in any of the A4 or the A3. First you go to the new, you see that pop-up menu that will come. Have you seen? We have written the width and the height. Go to here. When you go there, you see the instrument of measure being stated there. The pixel, the inches, centimeters, and millimeters. So you select the millimeters. You measure the object or the poster or where you want to place that particular design in millimeters or centimeters. So assuming mine is 210 by 210. I'll type the 210 at the width and 210. At the height too. Then I click on OK. Then when I click on OK, the system will generate that particular dimension for me. One thing you have to know is that in Photoshop, the dimension is very, very important. It is a key and is the base of which that design is going to be placed. The moment you finish designing the background and design fit that particular dimension, you have spoiled the whole thing. So always make sure that the design that you always do, you have the correct dimension. So it is always fine at the file. Then I click on it. Thank you very much for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you.